Anderson, there's just so much dishonesty and inaccuracy at this convention. It's hard for me to know where to start. And it's not just big things like this broad revisionism on the response to the pandemic. It's little inaccuracy, carelessness. We had someone, Laura Trump, cite a fake Abraham Lincoln quote tonight. A number of tonight's false claims came from the vice president, Mike Pence. He repeated one of Trump's own favorite lies. He said that because of them, we now have veterans' choice. As I've said over and over, Obama signed that choice law in 2014. Trump signed a 2018 law that modified and expanded the choice program, but did not create it. Pence boasted twice that Trump had, quote, suspended all travel from China. He didn't. He imposed a partial travel restriction that contained multiple exemptions. Tens of thousands of people, Anderson, kept coming over after that. Pence said again that Biden wants, quote, open borders. I know this is common conservative rhetoric, but it's just wrong. Biden does not support completely unrestricted migration. Now, Pence and others describe Trump's coronavirus response as a smashing success, and most experts we know say that's not at all true. But I think it's also notable how speakers like Laura Trump pretend that the pandemic did not happen at all. She said that 4.3 million new jobs have been created for women. Well, it was a gain of about 4 million since January 2017 as of March, but then we had a crash. And as of July, women have lost a net over 3 million jobs during Trump's presidency. We also heard more wildly inaccurate attempts to smear Democrats as extremists. We had Burgess Owens, a Utah congressional candidate, said that popular members of Congress promote the same socialism my father fought against in World War II. The U.S. wasn't fighting any actual socialists in World War II. The Nazis called themselves National Socialists. They weren't anything like Bernie Sanders, who, by the way, had family members killed in the Holocaust. They were ultra-right, genocidal totalitarians. We had Congresswoman Elise Stefanik call Trump's impeachment illegal. Come on, it's legal. Impeachment is in the Constitution. And like Trump himself, we had Press Secretary Kayleigh McEnany claiming that Trump stands by Americans with pre-existing conditions. Look, Trump has repeatedly tried to get bills passed to weaken Obamacare's protections for people with pre-existing conditions, and he's currently in court fighting to get the entirety of Obamacare overturned. Now, he has promised some sort of executive order protecting people, but it hasn't come yet, and Anderson, that certainly doesn't change his history on the subject.
Yeah, I mean, he actually has no health plan that he has talked about publicly or
announced. He doesn't.
Great.
Wonderful health care.
Yeah, yeah. There's been a lot of promises, and there's been, you know, movement by people in Congress and Republicans working on it behind the scenes, but we have yet to see anything from this president. And again, he's almost done with his first term.
Daniel, enough with Don. No, I'm kidding. Listen to Vice President Pence in his speech tonight. Do you judge this claim about Trump helping out veterans as factual or misleading? Take a listen.
And after years of scandal that robbed our veterans of the care that you earned in the uniform of the United States, President Trump kept his word again. We reformed the VA, and Veterans Choice is now available for every veteran in America.
Daniel?
Trump himself has told this lie, and it's a lie, literally more than 150 times as president. I've counted. Barack Obama signed the choice program into law in 2014. What Trump did do was sign another law called the VA Mission Act that modified and expanded the choice program, but still not every veteran is eligible. There are eligibility criteria for this program, which allows certain veterans to get covered for seeing private doctors outside the VA system. So no, it's untrue when Trump says it, it's untrue when Pence says it.
Now, Don, you may enter the conversation.
Well, I was just gonna say, don't let the truth get in the way of a good story, right? Daniel, and part of the law and order messaging tonight that Pence spoke about an officer killed in a riot in Oakland, California. That is not exactly what happened. Can you please give us the details?
It's not. So this is an example of how you can be dishonest without even making a direct claim. So when Vice President Pence talks about a police officer killed in a riot in Oakland or California, you probably think Black Lives Matter was the perpetrator, or Antifa, or someone on the left. In fact, the person charged with this murder is allegedly affiliated with the far-right extremist Boogaloo movement that seeks to kill police officers and take other actions to foment a second civil war or a race war. They're trying to use these protests as cover for their own ends. So again, Pence didn't directly say, you know, this was a left-winger, but I think that was the clear inference, and it's just wrong.
That's how I took it. I mean, it is dirty pool. All right. So, Daniel, thank you very much. Kirsten, the case was being made in this night of the convention for women. You had Lara Trump, Kayleigh McEnany, and then you also had Kellyanne Conway, who offered this.
For decades, he has elevated women to senior positions in business and in government. He confides in and consults us, respects our opinions, and insists that we are on equal footing with the men.
Does that work?
Well, look, there obviously so much of this, the convention has been targeted against, targeted towards Republican women, that they're worried about suburban women, that they're worried about losing. And so I think that a lot of the things they're doing, including talking about how much he loves women and how much he elevates women, I think they're exaggerating it a bit. In terms of, you know, comparing him to other administrations. I don't know that this is necessarily something that's going to make that big of a difference with the women voters. I think the thing that actually is more effective is the fact that they are portraying the party as a party that's very, has a lot of outreach and openness to people of color. Particularly, they had a lot of black men tonight, and I think that that gives permission to some white suburban women voters who are very uncomfortable with the racial demagoguery that comes from the president, and it could give them the sense that, well, maybe he's not as bad as they think he is.
All right, Mia, this is, I want you to listen to this. This is from Black Voices for Trump Rep. Jack Brewer.
Republicans are the party that freed the slaves and the party that put the first black men and women in Congress. It's the party of Frederick Douglass and Abraham Lincoln. And now, Tim Scott and Donald Trump.
There's a lot to unpack there, but... But what we didn't hear tonight was much about the reckoning over racial justice in this country. Isn't that a problem?
Well, yeah. I mean, you certainly want somebody to mention Jacob Blake, who's in the hospital. You want people to mention that. But the clip that you played, I have to say, could be pretty moving to some people. I mean, there was an actual effort to go out and say this is okay. And one of the things that he said in terms of this is okay, it's okay for black people to vote for Donald Trump. One of the things that he said that I thought was pretty compelling was, it's time to prioritize policy over personality. And one of the big issues that a lot of, especially Republicans, have is the personality issue, the issue where he can go out and be as brash as possible. This man, Jack Brewer, was actually making a case for saying it's perfectly fine to vote for him because the policies need to overshadow the personality.
I understand that, but I don't understand what the policies, what policies that this president has enacted that helps African Americans specifically, because especially when it comes to health care in this COVID time, we need that more than ever. And they have done everything they can to strip health care and the Affordable Care Act that helps minorities. I don't see how that helps.
I'm not here to defend the things that I'm talking about for everybody. Yeah, but what I'm trying to say is that there are some things, for instance, criminal justice reform that he signed into law that that a lot of people are supportive. The HBCUs that he funded, and Jack Brewer actually talked about school choice and trying to get as many people, as many black families into having a decent education. So changing what's happening in black America. So those are the particular things that he was talking about.
Well, you answered the question perfectly.